No one believes in their destruction out there. They don't believe there's a judgment. Man, half the people in the church don't even believe a judgment's coming. Which I just go, man, do you ever read this? Like, people go, well, I don't believe a loving God could judge. I go, get to page 2. He killed everyone. It's like, what are you thinking? They're like, well, you know, and I'm like, man, read about Egypt, read about, you know, I mean, the ground's opening up, it's swallowing up people. You tell me, man, do you read? And they're like, well, oh, you're just quoting Old Testament. Yeah, because he mellows out in Revelation. You just, you guys, but what the Bible says, though, is, it's our unity. When we're perfectly one and we're striving side by side, the Bible says they're going to start believing in their destruction and our salvation. Again, this doesn't add up to me. But I made a decision that even when this book doesn't make sense to me, I'm still going to submit to it. And whenever I disagree with this book, I assume I'm wrong. Okay? This is a big problem in our world today, is whenever your brilliant mind disagrees with this book, you assume there's something wrong here, rather than something wrong here. Okay? And this is what God is saying. He says, look, I know you have your new methodologies. I've read all the books. But I'm telling you, when you become one, like the Father and Son are one, when you become perfectly united, not afraid of anything, they're going to believe in their destruction. They're going to believe that Jesus was the Messiah, and they're going to believe that you were loved by God and that you are saved. And that's what Scripture teaches. And so our work this week is to say, you know what? I know I pretty much get along with these people, but am I pursuing this oneness?